woman. The woman is explaining to him where she worships. He said, we worship on a mountain. And he told her, you don't even know where you worship. He said, but there's going to be a time whenever we're not going to worship on the mountain or in the Jerusalem. He said, but true worshipers are going to be able to worship me in spirit and in truth. Tell somebody, that's the place. That's the place. That's the place that God wants to take me. It is a spiritual rest, y'all. It's a place, glory to God, like in the Old Testament, a land flowing with milk and honey.
Yeah.
Get up from to get to that place where God has assigned you, you got to be confident.
Yes, I do.
In God's ability.
Thank you, Lord.
And you got to be confident in what God has placed in you. Ephesians 6 and 10 says to be strong in the Lord.
Uh-huh.
My God. You can't be strong in yourself.
Okay.
My Lord. You can't be strong in others. But you got to be strong in the Lord and the power of
Jesus.
Oh, my God. What does that say to us? We have a spiritual authority, y'all. But it's in the jurisdiction that God has assigned us. Because we cannot operate outside the territory that God has given to us. We cannot operate and expect things to work out on our behalf when we are out of place.
Amen.
Now the word work. Whatever baby is on the inside of you. So labor is whenever your uterine begins to squeeze out the baby that's on the inside of you. What are you saying, Paul? Paul is saying, listen, while you're going through labor, what I want you to do is, I want you to sit firmly, established, and don't you move. Now, obviously, Paul don't know nothing about labor as a woman, because how am I going to have contractions? How am I going through labor, and you expect me just to sit still and be established and don't move? Obviously, Paul don't know, glory to God, the pain that we got to endure whenever we're going through the delivery process. Obviously, he don't realize whenever those pains hit us that we gotta do something. We gotta squeeze something. We gotta move something. We gotta scream. We gotta sit up. We gotta do something.
Enter!
When it seems like everything in your life is going wrong.
Yeah.
And see, as women, we associate that with we're birthing for something.
Yeah.
No, God said, I'm putting something on the inside.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you.
And everything in you is trying to resist it.
Oh, Lord. Help us.
God is trying to change your mind.
Thank you, Lord.
He's trying to change your thinking.
Yeah.
Glory to God. And so what has to happen is, God said, I am investing on the inside of you. And what I'm placing on the inside of you, God said, whenever people see it, they're going to say, how did a nation be born in one day?
Oh, my God. Hallelujah.
How in the world, Apostle? How? Where did she come from? I wasn't expecting this from her. Tell somebody, this is not what I even expected. I didn't expect it. Come on now. I didn't expect God to play something on the inside of me. All I know is I wanted more from God. All I know, glory to God, is I was seeking after him. Say, this is not what I expected. I didn't expect, glory to God, to call down fire from heaven, but it happened anyway. I didn't expect to go in a fiery furnace, to take God and not be consumed.